Hey, this is me back in 2013 seeing snow for the first time. Now 10 years have passed and I want to know exactly how good I got. Did I get any better at all? I don't know. That's what we're gonna see. Before going to Innsbruck, Austria for my first snowboard trip, I got 3 lessons in one of those. Still, I clearly had no clue what I was doing. Seriously, what is with the scarf? Dude can barely move. All I remember thinking was, 1, this is way too cold, and 2, why is it so much harder than on the PlayStation? Speaking of which, SSX on Tour was one of my favorite games growing up. The vibes, the soundtrack, the impossible tricks, like, seriously, what is this? Is this even legal? I don't know. But then I was struggling to stand up. A month later, I was lucky to have a second trip to the mountains, this time to Hofgarten, also in Austria. After some more lessons, I was finally able to link my turns. I felt like I was surfing the clouds. Those are some days I will never forget. Later that year, I was back in Brazil, and snow was nowhere to be found. Back in Europe again, I did go snowboarding indoors and even outdoors a few times. In 2022, I had my first snowboard trip in 8 years. Again, to Hofgarten, Austria. It was awesome. I had an absolute blast. Still, I was falling all the time. I could say that most of my snow angels were not exactly intentional. Up until that point, my progress was limited at best. But then something happened that changed the entire thing. I got my own snowboard thanks to this kid. This is my friend Gus. Vice asked me if I wanted his old snowboard. What? Of course, dude. What a legend, Vice. You are my hero. As a typical Dutchman, Vice flew way too much. Like, it's concerning. I don't even know. His old snowboard became way too small for him. It was still slightly too big for me. I'm 186, clearly not my problem. What, dude? Shut up. Anyway, it was time to try it out. It went much better than expected. I'm not gonna lie. That board is very stable. More stable than the Brazilian economy. That's not saying much. As I stopped falling too much, I started trying new things. That season, I did my first baby jumps, grasses, and regular jumps. I also forced these guys to do this. I'm sorry. When that trip was over, I felt bored, empty, lifeless. I needed some purpose. I couldn't just sit there and wait for next winter to arrive. So, I got to improvise. This gave me some momentum, and on summer I got a 2-month membership to Snow World.
Bitches love the ground.
That's when I did my first frontside 180s. Dude, I was flying. That was so worth it. In September, I faced my biggest fear. Deportation? Nah. The dry slopes. A dry slope or artificial ski slope is a slope that mimics the attributes of snow using materials that are stable at room temperature, aka plastic. In short, falling hurts. A lot. Don't think, maybe she won't rob you. She knows everything that I think. That girl, prettiest I could lose. My game's shittiest that could be. Waiting around to lose some time, trying to make believe you're mine. What are you gonna do? Come here, do you wanna come dance with me? In September, I spent a lot of time on the floor. It was cozy. In October, I reached the level I had on snow, and from there on, everything just got better. This year, it's been 10 years since I started snowboarding, so I want to know exactly how much progress I made. Let's go check it out!
Years and my life is still trying to get up that great big hill of hope for a destination. I realized quickly when I knew I should that this world was made up of this brotherhood of a man, for whatever that means. And so I cry sometimes while I'm lying in bed just to get it all out what's in my head. Outside and I take a deep breath and I get real high and die, scream for the top of my lungs. imagine. And I pray, oh my God, do I pray?
Alright, so this was fun, but this whole video would not be complete without coming back to where it all started. So, Innsbruck, we're back! Yo!
Cause when I see your face, I don't wanna die no more. Die no more. No more, no more. Every time I pray, all I'm asking for is another day. I don't wanna die no more. Die no more. No more, no more. You found my walls and tore them down. Never afraid of what you found. You know my past, you asked around. But you can feel I'm different now. Won't look back. Life ain't gotta be so sad. Dug me out the grave and you brought me back. I'll never be the same now, fuck all that. But now I'll...
Hey buddy, a little off-road sesh. Oh. Oh. What happened?
There he goes, one more.
We're gonna see me fall, probably. Woo! Oh, fuck! Man, my legs are broken.
So, in his 10 years, I learned more than I thought I would. Things like not bringing a banana in your pocket when snowboarding, or a hard-boiled egg. My progress wasn't that crazy after all, but it was just so fun. And there's one thing I know for sure. I will never forget any of the days that I spent surfing the clouds.
Nice foundation.
What do you think about the slopes, Arthur?
They are very good. Last slope, I think it's also very exhausted, you know.
If you don't have a bit of a nerve here, for us, you have to go in for the one time that I think come, they become the session strong, and then some of the things that not the commitment, not the source of the art, not the technique, but it'll
never be the same stage, right?